Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and very good morning. Okay, okay. So we continue our discussion for multiple signal on multiple signal transformation using graphical method. Okay, so we have done the first question. Okay, for this video, we try to solve the second question, okay, which is yt equal to 2 rec t, okay, alright, okay, so here I have the second question, okay, which is 2 rec t, okay, so as you know over here, so we have done, I have done the notation, okay, for the function, mathematical notation for the function, okay, and also the actual mathematical method, okay, the actual mathematical expression or mathematical method over here, okay. Okay, now we will try to take a look in terms of the graphical method. Of course, for graphical method, you need to draw the graph of 2 rec t over here, okay. So let me draw it first, okay. So this one, t equal to half, negative half, and then t equal to half. We have rectangular signal over here because we need, because we multiply with 2 over here, so the amplitude will become 2, okay, alright, okay, and then this rectangular signal become input our time scaling system. So let's do the process over here using graphical method. Okay, so as we know, t replaced by t and a half. Okay, so we know already t equal to t and a half. Okay, and then to make a difference, so we put t 1 over here. Okay, so, and then we try, and then we find t 1. Okay, so we find t 1 over here. Okay, so t 1, okay, t 1 equal to 2. 2t. Okay, so let's take a point over here, so you can have many points if you want. Okay, the more points you take, what I mean is point on t domain over here, t axis over here, the more easier for you to draw the circuit, the outputs, the graph, the output graph. Okay, so for example over here, I just take 3 points over here, so point A and then point B where t equal to 0, and then C when t equal to n half. Okay, take the first point first, point A. Okay, t equal to negative half. Okay, so t 1 equal to 2 negative half. Okay, so and then you will get t equal to negative 1. Okay, alright, for point A. Okay, and then you have point B over here, t equal to zeros, okay, so t 1 equal to 2 multiplied by zeros, okay, so we have t 1 equal to zeros. Okay, for point C, okay, t equal to half, okay, half, okay, so t 1 equal to 2 multiplied by half, okay, t 1 equal to 1. Okay, so let's draw, so we done the calculation, let's draw the graph, okay, the output graph for our time scaling system. Okay, look, point A, okay, so point B and point C, point A is negative 1, okay, point B is zeros, okay, over here, so point B is zeros, okay, so you have point B over here and point C equal to 1. Okay, the amplitude will remain the same. Okay, point A over here, the amplitude is 2, which is transition between zeros and from 0 to 1, from 0 to 2. And then for point B, okay, the amplitude is 2. For point C, transition between zeros and 2. Okay, and then we draw the graph over here. Okay, so we have here, and then we have here. Okay, so we do the time shifting. Okay, remember the input of time shifting is our output over here of our time scaling system. Okay, so we must, so we will do the same process as before. Okay, so first Okay, so since we replace t with t plus 4, so t equal to t plus 4. Okay, t equal to t plus 4. Okay, t equal to t plus 4. And then, to make it different, t1 over here, make it t1. And then we try to find t1 equal to t minus 4. Okay, so for point A, so you must take this signal, okay, because this signal is input of our time shifting system over here. Okay, please don't take this signal over here, okay, because it's not our input of our time shifting system. So you need to take this signal as a consideration because this is input of our time shifting system over here. Okay, so point A. Okay, so point A, okay, t equal to negative 1. Okay, so t1 equal to negative 1 minus 4. So t1 become negative 5. Okay, and then for point B, okay, t equal to zeros. Okay, so t1 equal to zeros minus 4. So t1 become t minus 4. Okay, alright. And then for point C, t equal to 1 over here, point C, t equal to 1. And then t1 equal to 1 minus 4. Okay, and then t1 equal to minus 3. Okay, so let's draw the graph. Okay, so for point A, negative 1, negative 5, negative 4, negative 3. So t for point A, okay, negative 5. For point B, negative 4. And then for point C, negative 3. Okay, over here. And then same thing, the amplitude remain the same. So we just draw it. Okay. Okay, alright. So let's do the final part over here. Okay. So the final part over here, okay. So t equal to over here, you need to replace t with minus t. So t equal to minus t. To make it different, put as a t1 over here. So t1 equal to negative t. Okay, remember, okay, take this signal as consideration in the calculation, not this one. Okay, not this one, because this is the input of our time inversion system over here. Okay, so point A, okay, t equal to negative 5. Okay, so t1 equal to negative 5. T1 become 5. Okay, and then for point B, okay, t equal to negative 4. So t1 equal to negative 4. So you get t1 equal to 4. Okay, for point C, which is this one, point C, okay, so t equal to negative 3. Okay, so t1 equal to negative 3. T1 equal to 3. Okay, for point C. So let's draw the graph over here. Okay, so you have 3 points over here, of course. Okay, T point 3, you have 5, 4, 3. Okay, for point A, you have T equal to 5. Point B, you have T equal to 4. Point C, you have T equal to 3. This one, point C. Okay, and then take C is from A is 0 to 2. So A is 0 to 2. The amplitude remain the same, just follow. For B, equal to 2. And then for C, negative C, 0 to 2 over here. Okay, and then we just complete the graph over here. Okay, then for stage by stage. Okay, let's do the direct method over here. Okay, so the same thing over here. Okay, so you must draw first the graph. Okay, for this one. Okay, so let's do the graph first. Okay, for this one. Okay, 2 recti. As we know, you have negative and half, and then you have 2 over here. Okay, the amplitude. Okay, for these cases, okay, because it's direct method, okay, the most you need to you have more points so that it's easier for you to draw the output of the system. Okay, so for example, I take this one, okay, this one, this one, this one, and this one. Okay, this one is negative 1, this one is zeros, and then this one is 1. Okay, so this one is point A, point B, point C, point D, point E. Okay, as you know, we replace T with negative T plus 4 divided by 2. And then to make different, we put T1 over there. And then we try to find T1 over here. So we have 2T equal to negative T1 plus 4. And then negative 2T minus 4 equal to negative T1. Okay. Negative T1 equal to 2T minus 4. And then T1 equal to negative 2T plus 4. Okay. Alright. So we take this equation over here. Okay. So let's do the first point where negative T equal to negative 1. A first point T equal to negative 1. So T1 equal to 2T negative 2T plus 4. Negative 2 minus 1 plus 4. So you will have here plus 4. Okay, you have here negative 1. So you have negative 2 plus 2 plus 4 equal to 6. Okay, for the first signal over here. Okay, so for point B. Okay, for point B, okay, for point B over here, where T equal to negative half, okay, so you have T1 equal to negative 2T plus 4, negative 2, negative half, okay, and then plus 4, so this one you cut, and then you have 1 plus 4 equal to 5, okay, so for point C over here, so for point C, okay, where T equal to zeros, T1 equal to negative 2T plus 4. Okay, so you have 2 multiplied by zeros plus 4. So T1 equal to 4. Okay, right. C, and then for point D, okay, for point D, okay, where T equal to half. Okay, so T1 equal to negative 2T plus 4. Okay, 2t plus 4 over here. And then you have t1 equal to negative 2 half plus 4. And then you have negative 1 plus 4. And then you have t equal to negative 3. Okay, right. And then for last one, point E. Okay, point E, t equal to 1. Okay, which is this one, point E, T equal to 1. Okay, so you have T1 equal to negative 2 multiplied by 1 plus 4. So you have 2. Okay, now we can draw the graph. Okay, we can draw the graph over here. Okay, so for point A equal to 6, point A equal to 6. This one, point A. Point B equal to 5. Point B. Point C equal to 4. Okay. And then point D equal to 3. Okay. And then point E, last point E equal to 2. Okay. Let's draw the graph over here. Okay. Okay. If you look here. Okay. Point A is 0. So we have 0 over here. Points B is 2 transition between 0s and 2. And then point C, you have 2 over here. point D, you have transition between 2 and zeros, and then last one, point E is zeros. And then you complete the graph. Okay, done. Okay, hopefully you can understand these two methods. Okay, for multiple signal transformation using graphical method, you can use step-by-step method, and also you can use a direct method. Okay, hopefully you can understand. Okay, thank you. And then for the next video, we will go the second chapter, which is a system